Now, let's talk about technology foresight. In fact, as the world moves forward, there are always some who can anticipate certain patterns. And those who understand these patterns are the ones who lead the trends or even create new ones. They're the ones who reap the benefits. So how can we become trendsetters? How can we develop such foresight? According to one source, there might be internal company experts or other technical experts or external consultants, along with publicly available data. Using this data, certain intelligent individuals can extrapolate various social issues, business matters, and key technological developments. Based on these insights, they can determine trends in business and technology. Whether it's these trends in technology or trends in business, if you're lucky enough to ride the wave, as Lai Zhen said, even pigs can fly, then you can really soar. So technology foresight, or tech trends in general, it's about seeing into the future, foreseeing tech trends and their impact on organizations. It's a method, a process. If we're talking about achieving technology foresight, well, first, you need a solid technical foundation and also be able to broaden your horizons, be experienced and knowledgeable. Often, we say someone is very smart. There are two aspects to this smartness. One is that they're naturally intelligent. The other is that they're experienced and knowledgeable. With more experience, they might be able to connect the dots or adapt ideas from elsewhere. We call it a cross-industry shakeup. All of this can help you improve. To focus on certain aspects, the possibility of foresight. We'll look at a simple example in a moment. As we can see, Minf published report on technology foresight. Technology foresight uses many tools, including brainstorming. Using brainstorming to explore various possibilities. Let's start with divergent thinking. Then we can have an expert panel discussion in a selective manner. We'll narrow it down. We'll focus our thoughts. Then there's also SBOT analysis. COT analysis focuses on our internal strengths and weaknesses, as well as external opportunities and threats. Then we have pattern analysis. We'll look at some IP analysis later on and the workaround method to get around certain obstacles, to carry out some development work, as well as trend analysis. These tools can help us better anticipate future technologies. Let's take a look. This is IT back in 2001 when they discussed technology foresight. For instance, they predicted that some advanced technologies like brain-machine interfaces would see significant development. Data mining, which is developing rapidly, biometrics, microparticles, robot design, microfluidics, open source technology, natural language processing, data management, and flexible transistors. But those were predictions from 20 years ago. In reality, these 10, let's talk about the key technologies for the future and what their current status is. 1% of them are actually developing quite well. Take data mining, for example, or big data analysis. Then there's biometrics, like the widespread use of code scanning for identification and voice recognition, and also natural language processing, such as nowadays, our speech to text. And voice recognition of various things is incredibly convenient. Another 1% has made progress, like brain-machine interfaces, robot design, and flexible transistors. The last 1% has seen almost no development, but that doesn't mean it's not impressive. It's actually quite remarkable, because it's inherently very difficult. It has implications for various future applications. We need to condense it from countless options to focus on just a few key areas. This is no easy feat, so it's still quite impressive. Then in 2020, they released another new one. Technology Review also highlighted the 10 most important breakthrough technologies. What are those 10? See if any of these ring a bell, like Messenger, data hosting, digital contact tracing and big data, multimodal AI, algorithm-based content recommendations, and lithium battery technology. For instance, ATL is a big name in lithium batteries, right? They've hired tons of people. Their stock is sky high too. And then there's algorithm-based content recommendation. Basically, like with Douyin and similar platforms, they can tailor the experience to each individual. Everyone's Douyin feed is probably different. What's recommended to you is based on what you've shown interest in. So a lot of companies, they're already on it, or gaming companies. They've been working on this all along, especially in tech foresight.